Prayer to Saint Francis of Paola, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O glorious Saint Francisco di Paola, who has demonstrated to us from the beginning a particular predilection, we again invoke the benefit of your charity. You have made a sign for us of particular favors and have made way for us instantly the care of your protection. We give thanks to you for so much benevolence and for the patron who himself deemed worth of giving you to us. Help us always in our necessities, even in the least degree, as we acknowledge with you the reign of God. In this particular way, we pray to you for the troubles that everyone has in the secrecy of the heart. We want to be your devoted ones. We want to live in your teachings and to be together with you as the loved ones of Jesus and Mary. You thus are the most acclaimed, the most loved, the most blessed, to whom we give our hearts. Together, pray for us and obtain for us the thanks of which we feel the urgency, the full communion with God and with the disciples. Living in charity, we will truly be Christians and reign within your love. Amen. May our Lord Jesus Christ, who repays most generously, reward your labor. You must flee from evil and drive away dangers. We and all our brothers, although unworthy, pray constantly to God the Father and to His Son Jesus Christ, as well as to Mary the Virgin Mother, to be with you as you seek the salvation of your souls and your bodies. Brothers, I most strongly urge you to work for the salvation of your souls with prudence and diligence. Death is certain, and life is short and vanishes like smoke. Therefore, you must fix your minds on the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, who so burned with love for us that he came down from heaven to redeem us. For our sakes, he suffered all the agonies of body and mind, and did not shrink from any torment. He gave us a perfect example of patience and love. For our part, we too must be patient when things go against us. Put aside hatred and hostility. See to it that you refrain from harsh words, but if you do speak them, do not be ashamed to apply the remedy from the same lips that inflicted the wounds. In this way, you will show each other mercy and not keep alive the memories of past wrongs. Remembering grievances works great damage. It is accompanied by anger, fosters sin, and brings a hatred for justice. It is a rusty arrow spreading poison in the soul. It destroys virtue and is a cancer in the mind. It thwarts prayer and mangles the petitions we make to God. It drives out love and is a nail driven into the soul, an evil that never sleeps, a sin that never fades away, a kind of daily death. Be lovers of peace, the most precious treasure that anyone can desire. You are already aware that our sins drive God to anger, so you must repent of them, that God in His mercy may spare you. What men conceal is open to God. Turn to Him with a sincere heart. Live in such a way that you bring upon yourselves the blessing of God, and that the peace of God our Father may be with you always. Lord God, by whom the holy are exalted, and Saint Francis was raised to share in the glory of the saints, let his prayer and example bring us the reward you have promised to the humble. Amen. Saint Francis of Paola, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.